So Ma'am Jessica has already done discussing that the different values that each prefix mean and the various symbols that you will be using as well as the multiplying factors. However, it is quite challenging really to convert quantities from this unit to the other unit. Alright? That's why I'm here to give you a life hack. Are you ready? Let's start. So, the first thing that you have to have is this table. You have to familiarize this because this will be your best friend as you do your conversion. Let's take for example, you have 25 kilograms and you wish to convert this into grams. Of course, you may still use the conversion factors that was discussed by Ma'am Jessica, but there's also an easier way for us to solve this faster. First step is you just have to write 25 kilograms, copy the base number. In your table, look the value of the prefix kilo, and that is 10 to the positive 3. Now just copy times 10 to the positive 3. And then, of course, grams. And practically done converting it. However, we also have to abide the rules of the scientific notation writing. So it says that our base should not go beyond the value of 10. So to make this less than 10, we have to move one decimal place to the left. Right? So this will become 2.5. times 10 to the power of something grams. Since you move one place, one decimal place to the left, that's what Ma'am Jessica said, when you move to the left, you have to arrive. You have to add. Okay? So this will become, instead of times 10 to the power of 3, this will become times 10 to the power of 4. And we are so done converting this into grams. Allow me to walk you through the process again. So you have 25 kilograms. I want to convert this into grams. This will be, I'll just write 25. Kilo means times 10 to the power of 3. And then I'll copy grams. I'll make this 2.5. I'll add 1 since I moved to the left by 1 place. And there you go. You're so done converting your 25 kilograms into grams. Other possible case that you can encounter in converting values from one unit to the other is similar to this. You have 25 kilograms and you are to convert this into milligrams. Alright? So the process is the same. Copy 25. Look at the value of kilo. It's times 10 to the positive 3. And then, look at your conversion goal. It's in milligrams. If you check the table, milli means times 10 to the negative 3. Now, all you have to do is get the reciprocal of your of the milli prefix, or the prefix milli. Okay, so this will become 1 times 1 over 10 to the negative 3. And of course, we will write here milligrams. So that will be 25 times 10. So of course, in your junior high school mathematics, you have 3 and then you have negative 3. All you have to do is subtract because this is the division rule of exponents, right? You just have to subtract. So you have 3 minus negative 3. You will get 10 to the positive 6. So this will be 10 to the positive 6 milligrams. So that's how we do it. I'll walk you through the process again. First, you have the given 25 kilograms to milligrams. Write 25. The value of kilo is times 10 to the positive 3. The value of milli is 10 to the negative 3. Get the reciprocal of that, right? Milligrams. And then you will have 25 times 10 to the power of positive 6 milligrams. However, again, you have to abide the rules of scientific notation writing. Our base is greater than the value of 10. So we have to, again, move one decimal place to the left. So this will become 2.5 times 10 to the power of 6 plus 1, 7 milligrams. So I hope this shortcut version of converting values from one unit to the other help you.